Hi guys, welcome or welcome back. For those of you who are new here, my name is Amber. For this video, we're going to be continuing series that I'm in the middle of. So this will be the second, call it an episode. We're first starting off with Kingdom of the Curse, which I just got done reading Kingdom of the Wicked, which is where you're following Amelia, who is a witch, and her twin sister Victoria ends up murdered, and you're following her along while she's trying to figure out who murdered her sister, along with there's other witches that are getting murdered. So she's trying to figure out who's going around murdering the witches, and she ends up teaming up with one of the princes of hell, and that's Prince Rath, and he agrees to help her figure out who's behind these murders. But she has been taught from a young age not to trust the wicked, but she is determined to figure out her sister's murderer, even if that means using dark magic, which is forbidden. So I did really enjoy that one. I ended up giving that 4 stars after I finished it. So now it's time to continue that. I also plan on, I don't know what, which one I want to go into next. I'm thinking either the next book in the Plated Prisoner series, which the last one I read was Glint, and I think the next one is Gleam. Let's see. Yeah, so the next one would be Gleam, and I'm enjoying that series more now. The first one, I think I gave 3 stars. It was okay. I didn't dislike it, but I also didn't overly like it. The one afterwards, I felt that same way for like the first 50% of it. I just really couldn't get into it. But then the last 50% I really enjoyed. And there was a plot twist at the end that I wasn't really expecting, so that makes me want to keep getting further into the series. And I see so many people that love it, so I still want to continue it and not give up on it. But I'm probably either go into that one or the next book in the Prison Healer series, which would be The Gilded Cage. I really enjoyed the first one. Again, a plot twist at the end that I really wasn't expecting. And it's been a little bit since I read that first one. So I think that might be the next one I get into, because I have been really wanting to get back into that one, into that series. I know that there's so many other series that I'm in the middle of. That's a tough one. We'll make that decision when we get there. Let's just get back to reading Kingdom of the Cursed. So it's been a minute since I've updated this. I am now, I think, like 60 or 63% of the way through Kingdom of the Cursed, and I meant to do a 50% update, and I hit 50% like 2 days ago. It's been either 2 or 3 days since I hit the 50% mark, and then I just forgot to update, and honestly, I'm kind of in a reading slump. I'm having a hard time getting through this, and it's not anything to do with the book itself. When I sit down and finally read this, I do enjoy it, but I find myself getting distracted very easily. Like, I'll read a couple pages of this, and then I'll find myself scrolling through TikTok, or getting on Instagram, or getting on YouTube, and just watching a video instead of just listening to, like, background music. And it's been ever since I read My Dark Romeo. And I don't know if it was that book. And it wasn't because I liked the book, because I really didn't care for that book very much. I don't know if it's from me like forcing myself to get through that book, because instead of just DNFing it, I was like, I have to see where this goes at least. And I'm already 60% of the way through. It's not going to take that much more effort to just finish it. I was wrong. It did in fact take that much more effort to finish it. And ever since then, I just have not had the want to pick up a book. And so I decided that I was going to take a short break from this, and I was going to start Bride by Allie Hazelwood. Even though I said I wasn't going to read this book this month, here I am. Because I was like, listen, I just need, even though this is like paranormal romance, I just need something that doesn't have really any world building, doesn't have anything that I really have to retain. I want just like a fun little romance standalone. And even that, I'm enjoying it. It's good so far. But I just cannot bring myself to just sit down and read. Every time I do, I get so distracted. It's taken me like 3 days to get through 10% of this book. But anyway, my biggest update is just I still love Amelia. I love her character. I
love Wrath.
The dynamic of all the princes of hell are interesting. I am confused, but like not in a bad way. I keep coming up with like my own theories behind things. This is spoiler free, so we're not gonna get super in depth, but there is like a mystery behind who the devil is, and I have my theories. And I'm interested to see if I end up being right or not. But I feel like she definitely, Carrie Maniscalco definitely gives you like little tidbits here and there. Where like at first, in the first book, I wasn't really picking them up. But then I started realizing that like some of them did, in fact, like give you a small hint as to what was going to happen. But some of them just didn't end up going the way that I thought they would. And I really like that. I like reading things and being like, oh, that could go this way. I like being able to do that in a book, and that definitely does this a lot, and I like it. There are so many times where I've just been tabbing and like underlining things. So overall, I am really enjoying this book. I'm just in a reading slump, but it has nothing to do with this book. So again, I do recommend the series because I am really enjoying it. I love the banter. I love how just explosive and sassy that Amelia is. I like one of the side characters that got put in here too, that you meet in this book. I am really enjoying their character. I hope that I get to see more of his character in here as it progresses because he's really funny. I want to know more about him. I want more of a background on him because it's definitely like you get small pieces of information, but none of them really give you like a solid background as to like why he's where he is doing what he's doing. And I want to know. I'm going to get back to reading this. I'm going to attempt tonight to sit down and finally read this and not scroll through TikTok or Instagram or watch YouTube videos where my sole attention is on that. I'm going to try to just turn on ambient music that fits with the atmosphere of this and focus solely on this. Let's hope I can actually do that and have the willpower for it.
So I want to do a little bit of an update. Was it yesterday?
Yeah, last night I ended up finishing Kingdom of the Cursed, and I am a little bit torn. I gave this 4 stars, but I don't know if I want to give it 4.25 stars because I enjoyed this more so than Kingdom of the Wicked, but I don't know if it was a whole lot because I kind of want to change my rating system. I feel like it's too much with what I have going on. I think I'm going to just do like 3 stars if something was like good, but I didn't necessarily love it, but I didn't necessarily not like it, and then go straight to 4 stars, and then 4.5, and then 5. I feel like it's just too much having like 3, 3.5. Sometimes I've given things 3.75, 4. It's just too much. I want it more simple. Final thoughts is this is getting a 4. I enjoyed it. There were parts where I was kind of losing interest, but I think that was just my mood versus the book itself. This one, I felt like there was a lot more going on, but I did guess how this was going to end. It was honestly pretty predictable, and I don't know, I think she might have meant it to be because she definitely gave a lot of hints throughout this, even starting in the first one, on kind of how this was going to go. So again, I'm not going to really knock it because it almost feels like it was intentional for it to be kind of predictable, which was also kind of nice because I didn't feel like I really had to overthink while reading this and read into every little thing that was said. So that was kind of like a nice refresher from what I've been used to lately. I feel like a lot lately I've been reading books where I almost have to like read into every little saying and try and remember it. I don't know. I feel like I'm just overanalyzing everything and thinking too much into everything lately, and so I'm kind of just trying to not hyper analyze everything that I read and kind of just more so enjoy it versus like just trying to nitpick at every little thing. So this does have a little bit of spice in it, but again, it's very minor, and I think if I'm remembering correctly, it was only like 1 or 2 scenes. And neither one of them were like overly detailed
they were very mild. Each one was maybe only like a paragraph or two. So you don't have to really worry about that. This is, I think, still considered YA fantasy. I know the first one's YA. But overall, I enjoyed Amelia's character more so in this. I feel like she has gotten a pretty strong character development. I liked the mind games that are kind of played between the characters in this one. You get to see more of the Princess of Hell in here, which was nice. I liked reading more about them and finding out more about each of their characters. I still love Wrath's character, even more so in this book. You definitely get a lot more of him in here too. Also, I'm interested with how this book ended. It leaves off on a cliffhanger that has me wanting to pick up the next one, which I did pick it up. I didn't really get to read a lot today. I did pick up Kingdom of the Feared, and I think I got maybe 5 pages in. I really did not read a lot of it at all because I don't know if that's the next one I want to pick up, but the way that this one ended has me wanting to go on to that one. And I'm so torn because tomorrow is when The Prisoner's Throne comes out by Holly Black, the second book in the Stolen Heir duology. And I don't know, I'm enjoying this world, but I think I'm getting a little bit, not bored of the world, but I don't know. If I'm not completely obsessed with the world and the characters, I can't really binge a series in one go. It's very rare that I've been able to do that, and pretty much the only series I've been able to do that with is the Once Upon a Broken Heart trilogy and ACOTAR. Those are like the only two series so far that I've just been able to binge like 3 books plus in a row without having to have a break with something else in between. So I kind of want to take a little break from this one because as much as I want to go into the next one, I feel like if I do that, I'm gonna get like 30% of the way through that book, get burnt out, and decide to just put it down and switch. Which I don't like doing that because my brain can't separate the fact that, like, it's a me problem. And then I somehow convince myself that the book was boring, even though I know that it wasn't the book, it was me. So I think me explaining all that just solidified that I'm gonna pick up The Prisoner's Throne tomorrow and start reading that. And tonight I did find a site that has, like, a breakdown for all the chapters from The Stolen Heir. I think I might try and just find like a YouTube video instead. I didn't like really look into it. I pretty much just clicked on like one of the first things that I found when I Googled it, but I think I'm just gonna go onto YouTube and watch a video instead if I can find one that has a breakdown so that I'm ready to read that one tomorrow because I feel like I remember a lot of what happened, but I also feel like there's a lot of smaller things that I forgot that will probably play a role in the next one. I plan on picking it up pretty much right when I wake up and trying to read as much as I can in the morning. And then in the afternoon, I will update you. This is the next book in the Stolen Heir duology where you're following Jude's little brother. Oh, it's like 7 years after The Cruel Prince ends, like that trilogy ends. He's now 17. I did start this last night. I have not gotten far at all. I think I'm 14% of the way through. I just got on chapter 2, which is like 30 some pages. Yeah, I'm on page 38. I'm just gonna show this real quick, but I'll block it off. But I love the artwork that's always on the top of all the chapters, and I like how in each book they correlate to like the character. And I want to say when there were like dual POVs, maybe I'm wrong, maybe there were never dual POVs, maybe I'm like mixing my books up, but I feel like in one of the books, even if it was just a couple chapters, there was like a dual POV at one point and it like switched whichever character it was, like the artwork would switch and it always correlates to like the character. But anyway, so far with this, I'm enjoying the book. But like I said about the first book, it was good. It's just, I don't enjoy the focus of these characters as much as I did Jude and Carden in the Cruel Prince trilogy. I really enjoyed their dynamic, their characters. I love Jude as a character. One of my favorite characters that I've ever read about. Oak, I just, he's getting more interesting. I don't know. I just don't really care for him as a character. I feel like, I know, like, the Fays in Holly Black's series are more of, like, the trickster manipulative type versus, like, what I'm used to reading about. I'm used to, like, SJM's writing of the Fae. And so I did like that change. I like the more unhinged version. And so I know that's how all of the Fae are, like, portrayed in hers, but it just feels, I don't know, too... The more I'm talking about this and the more I'm thinking about it, maybe I'm just overthinking on this book and this character. Because that's just how they're supposed to be. They're supposed to be tricksters, manipulative, you don't trust them, they do pretty much whatever it takes to get what they want. Because I was gonna say that it felt like she was trying too hard to make, like, another Cardin, but honestly, that's just kind of how they all are in. Maybe I'm just being too harsh and overthinking this a little too much. I'm gonna give this more of a shot, be more open-minded with it, I'm gonna try not to compare this duology so much to The Cruel Prince, because I feel like that's where a lot of my problem is I'm trying to compare this too much to that when it's its own thing, even though it's set in the same world. Anyway, that turned into more of a rant than I thought. I liked in the beginning of this, you get, like, kind of like a flashback into the first one, like it overlaps, and I liked that because it gave me a refresher. Not a lot. If you don't remember what happens in the first one, I would definitely still try and, like, look up a recap on that one if you don't really remember, because it gives you a little bit of remembrance, but not even remotely enough. But I did like that because there were some things that happened in, like, that first one, and they may have even happened at the end of the Cruel Prince trilogy that I just didn't remember. Like, when I read it, I was so confused for a second, and I was like, when did that even happen? So that was nice because I needed that, or else I would have been completely lost. If she wouldn't have, like, went in and described it a little bit, I would have been like, what? I don't care for how long these chapters are. Again, a personal preference though. I don't like long chapters because I can't focus for a long time, which I need to work on. And so I get, like, halfway through these chapters and I'm like, I need to take a short break. I need to go do something. And these chapters, I'm also slightly a slow reader, so these chapters tell me that it's going to take me like 23 minutes to read it, which seems like nothing, but my attention span is next to nothing. So yeah. Anyway, it's good so far. Nothing's really happened. It's more just been like a recap and then kind of just boring stuff. But you do get a further look into Oak's character. And I don't know if this was ever mentioned. It's been so long since I've read all the other books that, like, I don't remember a lot of what happened. I probably should have just done a reread of everything, but I was too lazy to do that. But there's something about him that I didn't know he could do, and it's interesting, and I really want to see where it comes into play in this book, because I feel like if it has been mentioned previously, it was pretty much skimmed over and, like, swept under the rug, but it's brought back into light in the beginning of this one, and I feel like there's a lot of potential onto where this could go. And I'm really excited to see that aspect. So I'm definitely intrigued. I'm excited to keep reading this. I'm glad to be back in this world. And I'm glad to see more of Cardin and Jude again. I'm going to get back to reading. All right, so I finally have an update for The Prisoner's Throne, which I feel like I've been reading this forever. I feel like this is taking me way longer than necessary to get through. Overall, I don't necessarily think that the book's bad. I think the problem is more so of how invested I was in the Cruel Prince trilogy, how much I liked those characters, that I just find myself not really caring about Oak and Bren. I just feel like I don't really remember much from the first book, but I remember liking the ending to the first book. And that's kind of how I'm feeling with this one. Like, I'm having a really hard time retaining and focusing on what's going on in this book, but I feel like it's getting slightly better now. But I felt like the beginning, just not a ton was happening. You'd get, like, small little parts where it felt like there was quite a bit happening, but then it just felt really slow. So I kept hitting these peaks, and then I was bored again. I just hit the 50% mark last night. I think I'm at, like, 51 or 52% now. And I, like, at the 50% mark, a lot was going on, but I'm feeling like it's gonna go back to being slow again. I don't know. It could be a me thing. It could be, I did say at the end of my last video that I felt like I was going into a reading slump. So maybe that's my fault for not just binging this right when I started it and kind of going off to something else. But I don't know. I just don't really find myself fully caring about the characters in this book. I feel like I care more about Hyacinth and Tiernan than I do Oak and Wren. So do with that what you will. I'm going to keep going and I'm hoping that this ends up being like the last one and I end up liking like the last 20% of the book. But I'm glad that this is a duology because I genuinely don't know if I would read the third one. If this was a trilogy. Reading this makes me want to go back and do a reread of the Cruel Prince trilogy and then just never pick these two up again. I'm gonna go finish this. So I ended up giving this 3 stars. I didn't dislike the book. I just really didn't overly like it. Even after the 50% mark, I felt like nothing big really happened until like 75%, somewhere around there. It might have even been like 80, 85%. I felt like there were just so many boring moments to me, and even by the end of this, I just still didn't really care what really even happened. The ending was pretty predictable on really what was gonna happen. There was like one small moment with Jude that slightly surprised me, but I mean, it took a very short amount of time to realize what was really going on, so that was kind of over. There was like one slightly, I won't even call it shocking, it was just like, it had me slightly on edge with Cardin. But again, I mean, you realize really quickly what's going to happen with it. I don't have much to say on it. Other than, it just really wasn't like all that great. I did like where she went with Ren's character towards the end. That was pretty interesting. But some of it just really didn't make sense, if we're being honest. Like, the way that things worked didn't really make sense. I know that's confusing. It's kind of hard to explain without, like, going into detail on what I mean by that. But, like, with Ren's magic, the way that the end was, I was slightly confused on how it worked. But yeah, overall, I mean, it's good. If you really enjoy Alfheim, I would still recommend picking up this duology. And just know, it kind of sounded like you were going to get quite a bit of Jude and Cardin in this one, and you don't. It's pretty small parts. But other than that, I think I just liked Jude and Cardin so much that it was hard for me to really connect with anybody else. And I still had that feeling even at the end of reading this. I still, as you can tell throughout this whole video, I definitely bounced back and forth between the thought of like they were too similar to Jude and Cardin, and then also me turning around and thinking that I was thinking too far into it. And that's just the way that the Fae are portrayed. But honestly, I think that some of the Fae are like that. And I think that they are all like tricksters, manipulators. But I also feel like most of them are pretty different from each other. And I just felt like the way that Oak and Ren were portrayed just came across too much like the way Jude and Cardin were. Like, their dynamic, the way that they are, they're like very base personalities, I guess you would call it, are just too similar. Like, I just personally think that Oak has too much of the basis of like pretense to not really care about the politics and just like very heavily manipulates people to like him and follow him. I just felt like that aspect of him was too similar to Cardin's character in the first one. And also with like Ren being super standoffish, not fitting in with everybody else, being very defensive right off rip, like always trying to be one step ahead of everybody else, just felt too much like Jude's character in the first one too. And their development also kind of felt too similar to theirs. It just, I don't know. To me, it just felt too much like it was trying to
take them and just put them with new names, with, like, different backstories. I don't know. Maybe I am still reading too far into this. Maybe it's just my crabbiness of being in a reading slump. I don't really know. That's just how I felt reading this. I just couldn't bring myself to really care. Honestly, the only thing that I really got out of this was me wanting to go back and read the Cruel Prince trilogy and just not finish this. I liked the ending more, but it wasn't enough to really hook me and change my mind on the story overall. It's just, it gets a 3 because it's good. And I definitely think that some part of me not really caring was me being in a reading slump. So I'm not going to knock the book. And ideally, eventually, I would have loved to go back and read this when I was in a better mood. But I know that I'm not going to do that. So I'm still going to recommend this duology to people who enjoyed The Cruel Prince, because I think a lot of people would love this duology. I think I was just crabby. I've seen people love this duology. I've seen people give this between 4 and 5 stars. I've even seen some 5-star reviews on this. So I'm not going to knock the book. I think a lot of it has to do with me. I think if I would have read this when I wasn't so crabby about reading, I probably would have gave this a 4-star. I probably would have enjoyed it more than I did. So, if you love the world of Alfheim, if you love sassy main female characters, if you like the, like, riddles and kind of, like, making it look like they're gonna do one thing, but then they do another type personality and characters, I think that this is definitely for you. Still love the world of Alfheim. We'll never deny that. The Cruel Prince trilogy is one of my favorite series. So yeah, 3 stars. Overall, I think the duology itself is like a 4-star. I think it's enjoyable. Yeah, that's all I have. My apologies for all the rants that I went on in this video. I really didn't think that I would talk as much as I did. That's not really like the typical way that I go about videos. I feel like most of my like reading vlogs are me reading, with like very little dialogue in it and very little, like, I pretty much just cover the basis of books. I feel like I really went on a full-blown rant in this video. So my apologies for that. But you know, I'm trying, man. I'm trying. But that's all I have for you. Thank you so much for watching. If you made it this far, leave the little, let's go with the crown, because both of these had to do with, like, kind of the royal political type. So if you've made it this far, leave a little crown emoji down below if you don't know what else to say. Let me know what you ended up thinking of. Let me know what you ended up thinking of The Prisoner's Throne. Did you like it? Did you dislike it? Was it just eh to you? Am I just being crabby with it? Or did you also kind of get the same feeling that it was good but not great? Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to leave a thumbs up. It helps tremendously with my videos. And make sure to subscribe to stay up to date with all my future videos. I will have plenty more continuing series that I'm in the middle of videos, hopefully coming up soon, because I have been trying to stick to those. I hope to see you in the next one. Bye!